In this illustration, we'll discuss about a man over a sliding platform. Here, the figure shows a man of mass M1 standing on a platform of mass M2. And here we are required to find the maximum force man can exert on a string so that platform does not slide on ground. And we are given that the friction coefficient between platform and ground is mu, and we can assume very high friction between man and platform. So here you can see that man is holding a string which is finally connected to the platform on which he is at rest. So here, if we draw the free body diagrams of man of mass M1, here you can see he'll experience his weight M1g in downward direction, and when force is applied on a string, he'll experience a tension in upward direction, and as a string can be considered as ideal, the value of force exerted by man will be equal to that of the tension in the string. And when the block has a moving tendency toward right, so it'll be experiencing a friction toward left. So man will experience a friction toward right. So in this situation, he'll experience a friction toward right. And if we draw the free body diagram of platform of mass M2, here we can see he'll experience a weight M2g in downward direction. And due to the contact between man and platform will experience a normal reaction downward, and man will experience a normal reaction in upward direction. And the platform will experience a tension T toward right and friction toward left. And another normal reaction which is applied by ground on platform will be N1 in upward direction. And here, as both are at rest, here we can see the friction which will act on platform due to ground will be F1, which can be written as mu N1. Because that is the only friction which can reach to a limiting value. The friction between man and platform F can be taken as very high. So this is considered as static friction. Now if we overlap the two FBD, we can see FBD of man plus platform can be drawn as a combined system, in which downward it will experience M1g plus M2g overall weight. In upward direction it is N1 plus T. Toward right it is Tn. Toward left it is mu N1. The normal reaction N1 will cause the friction on ground, that is mu N1, which is limiting value. So we can say just at the limit of a sliding, of a platform, here we can write N1 plus T is equals to M1g plus M2g, and the value of T is equals to mu N1. So in this situation, if we substitute the value of N1 over here, which is T by mu, we can calculate the value of tension, because we are just required to find the value of tension or the force exerted by man on a string. So here we can substitute the value of N1 from equation 1 to equation 2. So here we can write from equation 2, we have T is mu times the value of N1. We can write as M1g plus M2g minus T. So further, if we continue here, you can see the value of tension we are getting is mu times M1 plus M2g divided by 1 plus mu. That will be the final result of this problem. The force which man exert on a string to slide the platform on ground, or if the force is less than this value, platform won't slide.